Have you ever wondered how a truck really works? How it's built? How it's developed? Let us show you. This is Trucks Anatomy.
From Robert, can truck number two go to position?
Welcome to a very high-tech Trucks Anatomy. I'm feeling a bit like I am in a futuristic movie because this truck is driven by a robot. And this is how Volvo Trucks active safety systems are tested and verified. In a full-scale testing environment at the Asta Zero test facility, Volvo Trucks is developing a new method for testing and verifying their active safety systems on trucks. A testing method that ensures that the trucks meet all of today's strict legal requirements, even future ones.
As our active safety systems become more advanced, also our test methods have to become more advanced. And what we do here is basically that we can create any traffic scenario in the computer. And from the computer, we get drive files that we then program our robots in the truck so that we can create the exact same scenario on the test track.
Yeah, the main components of the system is actually a main computer controlling all the systems. It's a steering robot and a robot controlling the acceleration pedal and the brake pedal, and then also a GPS unit that controls the location of the truck.
Right, I'm here with Robert, and so what's the deal now? What's about to happen?
Yeah, what we have done now is that we have program the robot in this truck and a truck in front of us that will do a scenario where we will follow the truck in front of us, and then there will be an obstacle on the road, testing the emergency brake.
And the truck is driving all by itself? I'm not doing anything?
No, what you should do only is to hold this button here, the dead man grip that activates the robot. If you release that, then the robot will be deactivated.
Everything is set, you can start the test.
The test will soon start.
The reason why we do this are the increased accuracy and the repeatability, that we can create the exact scenario that we had in the computer on the test track, and we can repeat the same scenario over and over again with the exact same outcome. But also, if you want to vary a scenario, for instance, we want to change the speed or maybe the distance between the vehicles, this is also very easy to do because we just change a parameter in the computer file and then we program the robot and run a variation of the same scenario.
Okay, I will start the test in the laptop, activate the robot here, and then you can just go slightly forward and then you can activate the robot. Yep, that's enough, and then
now
you press
the button. Yeah. That's it?
Yep. Test started.
There we go.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah. it's a bit awkward, eh? The steering wheel is turning.
So now it will find a lane it should be located in and just follow the truck in the front of us.
He's following the other robots.
He's following the other robots.
So now when that one turns out, does now. Heavily, and I will just hold
tight. You can release the button.
I release the button, yep.
Perfect.
Very good. Not so long ago, this kind of technology was just fiction, something you would see in futuristic movies. Nowadays, there's nothing strange about this concept. It's in fact a necessity for the engineers at Volvo Trucks. It's their important work that helps drive the future for safer roads for all road users. And the emergency brake system that we tested here today will definitely be a helping hand in that matter. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.